My name is Rommie Amaro.
Yeah, we're definitely ready.
Here we go.
Wow.
Rommie is one scientist who's always trying something new, both at play and at work.
You see that hole where it just really binds inside? Yeah, that's fantastic.
I am a computational and theoretical biophysical chemist.
Whoa, say again?
I am a computational and theoretical biophysical chemist.
That's a mouthful. What Rommie does is study the structure and behavior of molecules to find better drug treatements for certain diseases.
What three things are you showing?
I was doing interactions with adenine.
We're currently working on African sleeping sickness and avian influenza, or bird flu.
It's a job that combines biology, chemistry, physics, computer science, and math. So for Rommie, being a chemist was just the beginning.
After I graduated from the University of Illinois in chemical engineering, I went to work for Kraft Foods, doing really traditional chemical engineering type projects, actually working on Philadelphia cream cheese, which was actually a lot of fun.
Always looking for a challenge and to make a real difference, Rommie went on to get her PhD and found her way to UCSD's Center for Theoretical Biological Physics, where collaboration is a huge part of discovering new drug treatments.
I think a lot of people have this idea that scientists work alone in either the lab or their office and they don't talk a lot to other people, but that is really not at all the case.
Here we have the same thing happening with this carboxylate group situating itself.
Rommie works closely with supercomputer scientists, computer imaging designers, and lots of other scientific experts throughout the research process.
We start with a protein structure, and then we use our programs to basically build a simulated system.
Once they've simulated the protein system with computers, they can then use computers to predict how the protein systems act and how a drug can actually change the structure of a molecule.
Once we have the data from our molecular dynamics simulations, we can visualize how these proteins are moving, either on our normal computer screen, such as at my desktop, or in a 3D visualization center, or in a virtual reality center.
This is a protein that's involved in African sleeping sickness. So we're trying to develop drugs that actually will bind inside this protein and prevent it from working. So this is really great. Typically, this is something that's about a billionth of a meter in size.
From there, Rommie collaborates with lab scientists to verify her computer models. And success means possibly a new drug that will save lives.
It's a really fantastic feeling.
But it also means a lot of work and patience.
It's one of the most fun parts of science when you do actually get it to work, because it's a discovery and it's very exciting. But along the way, it can also be extremely frustrating when you're sitting in the lab for a long time and it's not working.
Long hours and dedication are always part of the job.
Really, for me, it doesn't feel like work. Science is really a lifestyle. It's a hobby. Definitely, it's an intense job. But it's not like a typical 40-hour work week. So I'm just wondering the axis. I can't remember.
Oh, it's a time step.
Being a biophysical chemist is financially rewarding. But the best benefits of this job are the fringe benefits, because you get to travel, you get to feel really good about the work that you're doing, you get to work with outstanding colleagues.
Rommie also makes time for herself, either to chill or to crank it up a notch.
It was an awesome race. I feel fantastic. I absolutely love working out. I love doing triathlon sports and running.
Whether she's working out, flying over the ocean, or diving under it.
Awesome.
Rommie always leaves room for friends and family.
You don't want to miss that one. For me, that's very important, so I've always tried to maintain that in my life.
What's it take to become a computational and theoretical biophysical chemist?
You're probably going to take a lot of math courses, maybe some computer science courses, lab courses, of course, a lot of chemistry courses. You get to take a lot of courses in engineering, as well as traditional science areas.
So for Rommie, science is an adventure of a lifetime.
Here we go, yeah.
When you get to combine love of science and love of discovering exciting new things with your job, it just is a really rewarding experience.
Beautiful, now we can see the surface of the protein.
I definitely feel like the work that I'm doing is going to have a positive outcome in this world. and you're a scientist, the sky's the limit.
This is awesome.
Sweet. That was incredible. Awesome.